Well, I'm very sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but for reasons we needn't go into now, we've decided not to write anything at all for this week.
Nothing.
No, so if you don't mind, we'll just stand here and wait for our allotted 4 minutes to run out. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed.
What do I say we haven't written...
No, you don't have to explain.
No, I'm going to tell them. I mean, what is the point in us sweating our ears off to bring you the very latest in factory fresh comedy and amusing moments when it's quite obvious you're not interested in sophisticated, mature adult humour?
There's only one thing that interests you.
Exactly.
It's lavatory humour.
Yes. Just about lavatories. We can do that for you.
Oh, yes, we can easily do it if that's what you want.
If you like. There were two lavatories walking down Oxford Street.
No, that's not what's meant by lavatory humour.
Isn't it?
No, what's meant by lavatory humour is saying things like bottom, ploppies,
number twos, guffies,
moistness, nipple,
nipple.
You see? Say words like that and it's giggle, giggle, giggle.
I mean, I eat food, it gets digested, and I'm in the habit of pushing the waste product out of my bottom. Is that a joke?
Of course not.
No, there's nothing funny about that. I mean, would you rather I pushed it out of my nose?
It's all right, sometimes I get little bubbles of air trapped in my intestines. These need to be expelled. Occasionally we're with an accompanying odour, which is unpleasant. Not always.
Yes, always.
Well, always unpleasant. and a sort of loud cracking or flapping noise.
Is that a joke? No, it's not a joke at all.
No. How could someone having little bubbles of gas popping out of their bottom be funny?
It's all you're interested in, lavatory humour. Well, we're going to give you one last chance to prove that you're adult, sophisticated...
And mature and considerate young ladies and gentlemen. Mm. When we said earlier that we hadn't written a sketch this evening, that wasn't strictly true.
No, bit of a fib.
Something of a liella. We have, in fact, written two sketches for you.
Mm, two very different sketches. The first is called The Private Medicine Satire.
And the second one is called I've Got Rather a Sore Botty.
Now, if you'd like to hear The Private Medicine Satire, simply shout satire.
And if you'd like to hear I've Got Rather a Sore Botty, shout botty. Ready to shout? Now, please.
Botty!
Yeah, it's quite hard to tell. I think the botties had it.
Yes. The botties made more noise, anyway.
Well, they would, wouldn't they?
Yeah. OK, then botties it is.
I must say, I'm crushingly disappointed in you.
Not angry, just hurt, that's all.
And really rather disappointed. All right, so here we are. This is the I've Got Rather a Sore Botty sketch. Right then, Mr. St. Michael. Don't get up.
Actually, the name's Coverley.
Is it? Well, Mr. Coverley, you don't mind if I stand. I hope I've got rather a sore botty.
Not at all.
I keep forgetting. Not to worry. Now then, we've had a little bit of a look, a probe and a rummage, so to speak, and you'll be happy to know that your nipples are fine.
Good!
Yeah, look, you can have a look for yourself. Nothing wrong with them?
Well, are they supposed to be on my chest?
I think perhaps you'd better let me be the judge of that, Mr. Coverley. We sometimes amputate nipples so that when you die, they may live.
When I die, Doctor?
No, it's octa, actually. I dropped the D, considered it a frivolous affectation.
Oh.
Damn!
Gosh, that is sore, isn't it?
It's very, very sore. Now, returning to the subject of your death, if this piece of paper, divided into four, represents the human heart, what's happened in your case is this. Octa de Quincey.
Octa de Quincey. How long do I have?
Well, let me put it this way. Does your watch have a second hand?
Octa!
Yes, I'm afraid I give you less than a minute to live, but die happy in the knowledge that your nipples will give a chance for a young child to laugh and run and be happy.
Don't you think you're being a bit callous, Octa?
Oh, all right, I admit it. I've been kidding you all along.
Really?
Yes, look, I haven't got a sore bottom at all. But it is Doctor, not Octa. And look, these are nipples. They're really just cufflinks.
Oh, you old dog!
Yeah, you're still going to die, though. No, that's a joke as well. You're very seriously ill, but curiously, it's your lack of income that has saved you. Private patients can die almost immediately, but there's a 3-year waiting list on the NHS. You see?
Satire goes for nothing, isn't
it? Yes, we'll have to do it. We're going to have to do the lavatory humour ending here.
Go on.
All right. Private patients can die almost immediately, but there's a 3-year bottom list on the bottom guffy moistness bottle.